Hi everyone, I'm finally doing my review about the Kylie birthday edition from this year 2019. It took me a while because it took a while to come to France, plus I paid duties and I didn't get the liquid Kyliner, and I was talking with the customer service and they are saying it to me, which is not coming yet. But it's coming. Plus, I wanted this video to be a review and not first impression like I used to do. Because you have a lot of first impressions on YouTube. So I just thought, wow, it's still in stock. Maybe she will restock something. So I will do a review to know if you're like that, you can know if you need it or not. So let's. I took the favorite bundle, which contains the palette, one shimmer eye glaze, the velvet lip kit in Kylie, high gloss, the lipstick trio, you know, with the box, and. A jelly highlighter, and I took with that the liquid eyeliner, which is not here, and the face primer. So that being said, let's get into the video. So I will first go with the palette. So I don't have all the packaging here, forgive me, you have everything on the internet. So it's super cute because you have the bills, you say bucks, and the palette is like that. Even if I'm sure you saw it everywhere, so it has been loved, as you can see. I used it almost every day since I received it. What can I say? You have multiple formulas in that palette. She did again the glitters, like Huda Beauty, I think she does that, which is this consistency with oil or something like that. So it's great. So as I said, you have different formulas, the mattes, of course. They are buildable. You have the payoff as at the first time, but you can build this. It's what I prefer because, you know, sometimes on the morning you're like, let's go, and you have messed up everything. Anyway, so you have the mattes. I like. The only shade I didn't really try was the bright pink. I'm sure it's good. It swatched well, so I think it's the same for everything, for every color. Then you have the glitters like the beauty. So my favorite is this one. It stays put, like I would say, all day long, but you will not pass the evening and neither the night. Then you have like normal glitters, metallics. Well, you can say metallics, like this one, yes, and this one, I think this one too. And for this one, I would say it's more like shiny than glitters. I wouldn't say metallic either. I don't know what you think. It's more. Yeah, swatches everywhere. It's more shiny. It makes me think, it's this one. It makes me think about Mooney in a ColourPop collection with Kathleen Lights. I didn't swatch it, but I think it's quite the same color. And you know that thing about ColourPop and Kylie, are they the same thing? They have the same ingredients in their formulas. She went out with the jelly highlighter and ColourPop had something similar to this. So, we never know. But about the palette, it's quite a great palette. I don't remember the prices. I may put everything in the description if I don't forget. Yes, it's a good color scheme. Well, pink and greens. You still have some. Like you have the brown here. Yes. You have a purple there. Like kind of a pinky neutral there. It's a khaki and not like a forest green, so you can use it. I use it every day, so it's kind of a everyday palette. So wow, good job. Then to stay in the eye product, you have the shimmer eye glaze. I got the one so in the bundle, so it's Timepiece the name. So I used it a few times. It's not the best. Oh no, sorry. It's not the best formula ever. It's the one I have right now. If you put too much on, it can flake off. But if you're doing it well, it can. So it's kind of not natural because it's not natural, but it's not like a big flake on your face and it won't flake off. Yeah, it's still so you can build it. Build it. You have a good payoff. So I think it was twice, two times here. It's not transferring, so I didn't get this one for all day, but it's not transferring for now. And usually it's not transferring before the end of the day or beginning of the evening. It stays on the lid, and what I was thinking is strange because this one is kind of it's like a penny color, kind of orange thing, but the color scheme is green and pink. So why? It still work. I used the palette also. I used the brown and. I use on the budget, which is the a pink here, like a medium pink, but not the neutral pink I was talking about earlier. And I used underneath my eyes Breaking Records, which is the like purple burgundy, and the brown here on the outer corner of the upper lid. Yes, so that's for Dimepiece. Then we have lip products. So here is the packaging for the Velvet Lip Kit in Kylie. So it's funny, yeah, it's funny. Let's not talk about the packaging, about the money. But yeah, I think it's cute, the green with the pink here. And it's even written in. I don't know if you can see in green here. So yeah, it's cute. It's the same color as the. It's what I'm wearing right now. It's the same color as the matte one. It's very comfortable as all the velvet she did. But I'm not convinced. I just prefer the matte formula. But it's really comfortable. It stays put a long time. So yeah. It's like regular stuff, so I just say yes. If you prefer the velvet, go for the velvet. If you prefer the matte, go for the matte. And it's just up to you for that. Then we have the One in a Billion High Gloss. I don't know why she didn't put some green on that one, but yeah, it's the same. As the all the high gloss, I love the high gloss because they are moisturizing, comfortable, and not sticky like It's always a little bit sticky, but it's not sticky for gloss. Here you have the color is kind of peachy translucent, because I have dark lips, so when I put this, I just don't see the peachiness. And the glitters are really fine, and you have pink and gold glitters, which I like. Like, it's not my favorite, but I like it. I just like it. Then we have the lipstick trio, and it's our usual matte formula, but I don't like the colors at all. I thought I would like these two, not this one because it's too pale for me, and I thought this one will be like my favorite, that I will wear all the time, but it's not working for me. I think it's too peachy. I thought it would be more wooden pink, and it's more peachy, I think, well, on my skin tone, and I don't like. So actually the one I prefer is this one, but still I won't wear this every day, so, but well, they work like our usual formula for the matte. I prefer the matte over the cream. Yes, it's cream. I have a lot of this, like the cream and everything, but I just don't wear them. It doesn't stay put, and I'm always drinking everything. So you have the horns here with the, when you have your glass. I was already told you, I think, about that story, but yeah, the only thing I wear is a formula that's not transferring there with the glass or the bottle. Anyway, then I will, so it's good, it's good. It's just if you like the stick, go for it, but the colors I don't like, actually, well, on me. Then you have the pink paper jelly highlighter. Well, I like the color for this one. It's what I'm wearing right now. I don't know if you can tell. I even put some like here. As you can see a little bit, I put on my nose. Also, so yeah, I like the color. I think it's the one I would go even if it wasn't in the bundle. But I think it's too complicated. It's too messy. I just wanted to put some on my face. I still have some on my fingers. I had too much on my fingers, so I did a swatch for you. It's a swatch from earlier, so I think you cannot see anything. No. This is just my water eyeliner. So that's, well, I was going to say Mooney, no, yeah, it's beautiful, but it's too complicated on the morning, so quite useless. If you need like 5-10 minutes to put your highlighter, then, or maybe just me with creams and liquids, products in makeup, I'm like, it's so simple with powder, so why would I take that liquid highlighter? And it's too complicated. But I put some foundation, but I didn't set my foundation, so that's the result with the highlight on top. I think during the summer, when you're not putting any foundation, could be great, because you just ta 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 and that's it. But with your foundation, you're like small by little by little. I did with my finger. Maybe it's easier with a brush, I don't know. Like, if you have some tips, I wanna know, because I'm very bad with cream and liquid in general. Which goes to the last product, the face primer, which is a liquid, but you understood, it's not the same thing. I think it's comparable to the Marc Jacobs and Too Faced Coconut Primers. So it's good, it works, it's moisturizing, hydrating. Is it worth? I think it was $28. I'm like, yeah, the Too Faced face primer is like 32, I think. Let's not talk about Marc Jacobs. So 28, I think, is in the range of the price of face primer. She says that you have good ingredients in it. Maybe. Well, I didn't have any bad reactions. So it worked for me, it worked. And what I would say that it's good for normal to combo skin, but I'm not sure it will work for dry skin. So maybe you need more, or underneath that, maybe you will need your good moisturizer. Up to you. But I think for dry skin, it's not enough. Just not enough. So, that's it for my review. If you have any question, please put a comment and let's talk about all the products in the comment section. Bye, everyone.